Hey, buddy, it's Evicta. It's time to need a streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but the previous one did. We're now sitting at 10 away from the ultimate like streak goal of 60, which I'm looking forward to. Again, 10 days or less, and if that other video does cross 8,000, I will be keeping an eye on it and adding another one retroactively. So definitely go check out the death certificate video if you've not already. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by, I believe, first time, maybe, no, this is actually the second time submitter, I remember. Gaming Spud 667. I just reread the name and recognized it. Tile Threader was Invicta when he has 4.04 damage. Basement 1. Hey, feeling pretty good. By Scarred Womb 1. Or we're not feeling good anymore. Thank you very much, Gaming Spud 667. Let's hop on in here. Today's Eden Run. Find out what we got going on today, coach. Oh, boy. Today's going to be Foxtrot, Juliet 2 Delta, Mike, Romeo, Victor 9. We've got 0.5 movement speed. Yeesh, that's all you gotta know. 0.5 movement speed is just god-awful. Good everything else, though, I will say. Okay, we'll just walk right through the door then. Yeah, I mean, with 3.08 tears rate's very good. 4.06 damage. Hey, it only took us one day to improve that damage stat, didn't it? That's right. We, have Thunder Thighs, and Thunder Thighs is going to allow us to have the stompy effect, which allows us to be able to walk over stuff and destroy it without us having to actually use bombs or anything like that. I am planning on going back to get that black card, but obviously movement speed upgrades are what we're looking for right now. That's going to be very dangerous if we don't get enough damage in order to compensate for the lack of movement speed. It could get out of hand very quickly. We also have the Azer Raid, which is going to be our space bar item, and that will cause us to take a little bit of damage, but we will gain a big damage buff because of that. It's basically Eve's starting item, so it's very good for if you need to get down to low life quickly, but you have, like, you know, sufficient soul hearts to protect you. It can give you unlimited amounts of damage. It's very, very good with Rock Bottom, of course, because you essentially just turn all HP gains into damage permanently. But we don't have that, unfortunately. So, do my due diligence here and just walking over some rocks. We're probably not going to go into the store. I don't really think there's any need to. We're going here as well. By the way, I know that I said at the beginning of this video, I said time to continue the Eden streak. Technically not an Eden streak anymore. It's just a win streak. And it's been a lot of fun. I'm glad that people have been enjoying the mix up here. I'm still, like, kind of iffy on doing, like, themed days, because, like, there may be some days where I don't feel like playing a tainted character. But, you know, other days where I'm just like, you know, I really just want to play an Eden run and that sort of thing. So, but for now, what I'm going to do is we're just going to be bobbing and weaving. We're going to be weaving in some random runs there. We're going to be weaving in some tainted character runs and, you know, just having lots of fun doing it too. Hopefully you're having lots of fun as well. We might as well go finish out the rest of this level here, just in case if there's going to be a tinted rock, which there is. It's right there, and we're going to run over it and get a soul heart and a key. Well, ain't that lovely for having a key? Might as well check the store while we're here. So, but obviously, again, the biggest crux of our issues currently plaguing us in this run is going to be the lack of movement speed. I'm going to go back and go get that black heart, and then we'll hopefully... No, we probably won't make it in time, yeah. Yeah, even with good movement speed, we do not have enough movement speed to get out of that door before the iframes wear out, especially in Repentance. But if you notice there that we now have a full black heart instead of a full soul heart, that is just by choice, by design. Take the black heart, and then you refill it with a regular soul heart. The black heart is the one, if it precedes the soul heart, it will become a full heart. And yeah, it's just a nice little trick for you. Also, take this opportunity to shout out the Reddit Mosh Pit. We've crossed 20,000 members on this Invicta subreddit. That is just so cool, man. Thank you all very much for doing so. I truly enjoy interacting with the Reddit community, and I really, really enjoy just reading all the posts. You know, it's just another branch of the Mosh Pits, the Reddit branch division of the Mosh Pit. It's very cool, you know, and everyone, of course, intermingling with each other on the Discord and, you know, coming over from YouTube and going into Twitch chat and that sort of thing. It's just a good time. It's a golden time to be in the Mosh Pit. Fortunately, not many keys, so I can't get in there. Don't shoot the fires in here because most of the mulligans, if not all of them, will just yeet themselves right into the fire. We do get Mom's contact, which is very good at freezing and basically just crowd controlling enemies. Very, very powerful, especially for bosses. But again, the biggest problem that we need to overcome right now is movement speed. Wow, that Diglett shot, paused, and then shot again. So usually what happens when the Diglett does that little wind-up animation, that right there, but doesn't shoot, that usually is their chance to fire. And the one that hit us already did that, at least in my mind anyway, bro. But got frozen by Mom's contact, and I guess that reset its attack cycle, and it shot us again. But you just saw from that room right there just the problems that we're going to be having here directly related to having no movement speed at all. You know, chasing around one singular Diglett around a room is dangerous enough, and then you've got the Stonies who are just pushing you, and we almost got hit by a spider, and it makes dodging very difficult. Very difficult. We need some Yaves here. So I'm hoping that we get some good Devil Deal items. I mean, like, we've never been this desperate for a speed upgrade. Things are going to start winding out of control in a hurry if we don't get some kind of mobility upgrade or, you know, just anything, really. Anything we need that can help us right now in terms of movement speed. And we're going to be able to bomb our way into the item room. Really stupid Stonies first. And then we're going to destroy the pots. The reason why I want to do this is because in case if we do get spiders, we can just walk out and walk back in without having to reset the room. We cannot walk over these mushrooms. If we had more HP, I totally would, but yeah. We have Bozo, which is going to give us a little bit, a tiny bit damage upgrade, but we cannot get a key. And using those two keys for the vault was a calculated miscalculation error. So we have to hope that old Dookie drops us some keys or something, or, you know, latch key would be great. But again, the biggest of big time plays right now would be a movement speed upgrade. We want movement speed. The mark is movement speed. Not a lot of movement speed, but hey, it's a freaking start. Yeah, so when 0.70 feels like we're streaming and screaming across the world at light speed, you know it's a good run. I'm gonna slowly meander our way over here to the curse room. There's usually not very many keys in here. And so what I should really be doing here is I should be using the Azerade to proc the iframes and then walking through the cursed door like that. So we're not taking direct damage on our soul heart. So that's totally my bad. I wasn't really thinking. But we are going to sacrifice an entire library and the store with even though we got the quarter. Unless if we find the super secret room and we're able to find a key in there. Well, we found it. Maybe? We could try to take one of these and hope that it's a bombs or key, but if we get a speed down, I'm going to lose my mind. I love how we're getting all these, like, really laborious room layouts, because the game's like,
nice movement speed, nerd. Oh, here comes another maze.
There we go. So again, we use our iframes with the Azerade to get through the cursed room door so we don't incur any damage penalty on our soul hearts, our very valuable soul hearts at this point. And those little flies that you see there, they're given to us by us having the Rotten Heart. Oh my god, it's a key. They do exist. But man, oh man, this is, oh good. The fact that we got out of here without... You know what? Cardio coin, you're just going to have to deal with it. The fact that we got out of that room without taking damage at all against the wide-eyed Globins is just astounding. I thought for sure we were going to lose one or two soul hearts in there. I was prepared to use the razor blade to save our soul hearts, but thankfully we didn't. I was so shocked that we didn't get hit in there that I was really moved by that. That one fly ran the other way. I think it was because it got briefly charmed for like half of a second, and that's what caused it to move. Pro Hut's tip here, don't destroy the black poops in this room, because if there's any consumables that fall, instead of falling in the middle two blocks, unless you have flying, those are usually inaccessible, it will fall over here where it is very accessible. So now we're gonna play chicken with the game. We're gonna say, okay, here we go, game. We're gonna go to the shop. Because we have 54 cents, possibly more if we go back and get cardio coin, which I'm still angry about right now, and hopefully not have a greed fight. The idea here is that we're going to get a reroll pedestal in here, or at least at the very least a restock machine that will give us more keys. And we get Humbling Bundadu, which is just a beautiful, chocolatey, legendarily amazing upgrade for us. I don't even know why I said chocolatey, but you know what? It sounded good. Red stew doesn't really matter right now. Like, the damage we get's good, but we can't move fast enough to really utilize it to the fullest. Doctor's remote, which, yeah, I mean, it's better than... The razor blade is not terrible. Again, especially if you do have rock bottom, which we don't. If you have excessive amounts of red heart HP, it can be very, very good. But at least Doctor's Remote allows us to get a free bomb off, and it does a pretty good amount of damage by itself, which is something that we don't necessarily need a whole lot of right now. But it is good for at least, you know, doing some pretty big damage on bosses. Unless, of course, you miss. Bighorn kind of froze up there. We gotta be careful about him dropping the bombs on us. Yep. And you see here, our damage is still competent for now. There we go. Another HP upgrade, and we are heading on down. Fine, I'll go get the cardio coin. Victor, don't you complain about money for the rest of the run if you don't go back and get that cardio coin. Oh, good. That's when we thought we didn't have to go through this room again. All right. Here we go, cardio coin. All right. We're moving. Speed of light. Gonna make a supersonic man out of you. Is that what Freddy says? I don't remember. All right. So we are okay damage wise. We don't need to be Stompy. We've already got Stompy. Super Secret Room could be somewhere over here. I'll try one bomb just to test. Okay, and we get some bombs back here. Maybe give us some keys, buddy? All right. Easiest way to deal with that room right there. Oh, we are feasting now, boys and girls. We be feasting. Look at that. Look at that. Get another charge on Doctor's remote. And all of a sudden, it's turned around to be a, just a we're moving. Warp speed here. Look at that. We're making moves. Getting money. Missing shots. We're like a regular stormtrooper over here. All right, there we go. Although I'm not sure if stormtroopers... Do stormtroopers get paid? Surely they've got to get paid, right? I would imagine that there's some kind of like base salary for a stormtrooper. In the canon of Star Wars, by the way, if for those of you who are very confused right now. I would assume that stormtroopers had some kind of base salary. Jedis too, Jedis have got to get paid somehow, right? They just can't live off of leaves and like hugging trees and stuff now. They gotta have some kind of monetary value somewhere. Whoop-de-whoop. Some shoop action going on here. Shoop definitely is going to be a very nice addition to this run here, especially considering that it does borrow the properties of certain tier effects, one of them being the freezing effect from Mom's contact. Basically pays for our curse room. Okay. Sacrificial altar does literally nothing for us, unfortunately. And we continue to get more and more money here when we're not really trying to, which is not a bad thing. It's not a complaint. Yeah, I made y'all a little worm bridge here. So we do have a sacrificial room as well, a sacrifice room, and that's actually got me pretty excited for the possibilities here. Now, if we're going to play the sacrifice room, we need to play it now before we go fight the devil deal. But the problem is that we also cannot guarantee that we're going to get these soul hearts back. Got most of the room here with that shot. That's pretty good. Lusty Blood. Lusty Blood is going to be a very nice addition here. Petrified Poop. You want to wait until the poop actually gets into your trinket slot before you start destroying it. Destroying poops. Otherwise, they won't count. They won't get the bonus for the consumable drops. Yo, Bloody Lust is going to give us a damage upgrade every time we kill an enemy in a room, and that's going to wear off after... we leave the room. Take school bag, meow, and a half price soul heart, meow. And we're going to go drop a bomb, meow, and get ourselves a devil deal, meow. Secret room might be here. It could have been there. I should have probably looked to see which one this is. Yeah, okay. If I had seen this, I would have known that it cannot possibly be there because there's no gap there that we can cross. Our damage does max out pretty nicely here. We go over 10 thanks to Lusty Blood, 10.68. I believe that's the maximum amount we can get. And Shoop the Whoop's gonna be very nice for Lusty Blood because of the fact that we're able to kill things quickly. That means that we're able to boost ourselves to like, we're kind of like supercharged with that damage, the damage proc from Lusty Blood by just thanks to the pure lethality of Shoop the Whoop. Super secret room is there, and yeah. I can use Shoop in here because obviously we want to save it for the boss. Get some bombs, some bombas. There we go. So we got the freeze off and the shoop off for pretty much full duration. Humbling Bundle, by the way, is going to give us +1/+1 for pickups. A clean stain fight, and we fail a 73% deal with the devil. So, about the most predictable outcome that you could have possibly imagined. So now we're going to slowly make our way over to the sacrificial room and hopefully get ourselves some kind of stat upgrade for our speed. You know, getting a tears up, especially with Bar of Soap, is very nice because it's a pretty strong tears up at that. But that's not what we're looking for right now. What we're looking for is we want, if we're going to get quality upgrades, we want to get quality upgrades for the stats that we want. And tears would be one of them, admittedly. It is one of them, but certainly not our most important one that we have right now, or lack thereof, which is, of course, the speed stat, what we've been talking about for the last 20 minutes or so. And this is all direct. This is all directly because of the fact that we have Thunder Thighs, which is not an item that I usually go for that much. We get Redemption again. We got Redemption. Was it yesterday's that we got Redemption on, or was that on stream? I don't remember. Maybe Uriel. I have no interest in fighting Uriel. And we didn't get the payout. Just gonna troll Gabriel.
Good one, Sinvicta. Got him.
All right, so we get Redemption, which is an item that's going to give us a damage upgrade, a fairly sizable one at that, admittedly. Redemption is very strong. And basically, we get rewarded for not taking anything out of the Devil Deal. Now, I didn't mean anything, I mean nothing. If you do take, and actually now that I think about it, it was on stream because I talked about this fact. If there's, you know that one Devil Deal where you walk in and there's an item in the middle and there's two black soul hearts on one on each side of the item. If you have Redemption and you pick up one of those soul hearts, that will count as you basically taking an item, a Devil Deal, and it will cancel out the Redemption bonus, which in my opinion is kind of silly because it's not like we're taking an item out of there. I think that it should only kick in if you take an item. That being said, though, Redemption is very, very good. It basically gives you a direct damage up, which is something that you usually are looking for inside of the Devil Deal anyway. So the compensatory nature of Redemption is adding value to a Devil Deal that normally you wouldn't take because you don't need anything. Unless you're in like a specific situation like we are right now for like, say, oh, I don't know, a movement speed upgrade. It's Silver Dollar here. And we're going to play this down to basically nil. Basically naught. Flooded Caves and 21 minutes. Yeah, looking good. Follow the dog. Yep. Charge is pretty good here. I mean, really all I wanted was just like Goat Hoof. But now we're gonna put in literally almost an entire dollar, and this is what we get out of it. Not a bad payout. We also got a reverse Justice card, reverse Emperor card, which we can use right now. But you kind of wish that we had a charge and shoot. I don't know what I was expecting there. I guess I wasn't expecting them to shoot that fast, like that quickly. Oh my gosh, we got a speed upgrade! Sisters Vis, I love you. Big time plays. We also have Brainworm. I'm going to take Trickle Charge, though. And if we find the secret room, we can use the justice card, the reverse justice card in there to possibly get a secret room chest. But this is predicated on us finding the secret room, which we have not seen yet. We've now seen the secret room. Mm-hmm. Very important to clear out half of this room. Man, oh man, look at the absolute difference it makes for us to have 1.0 movement. 1.0 movement speed. Might as well use a bomb here to get this nickel. So yeah, so overall, after it's all said and done, Unflooded Caves 2 is a very big floor for us. We did get an Angel Deal item thanks to the Sacrificial Room. We got a Tears upgrade, and most importantly, we got a Speed upgrade. So super stoked about that. Let's go grab the... we want Empress card, Tower card, Fool card. We don't. I mean, the silver dollar is nice and all, but like trickle charge allows us to use Shoop to Whoop after every room. A dice room in here. And it's an in the room D Twanky. Notice now that Shoop to Whoop will be usable after every room now, which is very, very, very good now. Again, movement speed, if we can get some more of it, I'd be happier. But I am very grateful for what we've already been given on this last floor. Flooded Caves 2 was the MVP right there. And that Reverse Emperor card, really playing down the fortune-telling machine was it. That's what really gets credit. It was the decision that we made to play the fortune-telling machine. Good shot there, Shoop. Almost got the entire room. That's pretty hard to do, I'm not going to lie. Great shot with Shoop. Now, we didn't get a charge there because technically we weren't really in combat because those flies were both not spawned by the room. They were optional. But this is one of those runs that is just slow, methodical. You know, it's a little bit of a slog, but educated decisions and good ideas create opportunity with this run. And those can be some of the most enjoyable Isaac runs that you can find. The runs where you have to play the game slowly. You know, I'm not saying it's always fun, but they can be fun. Being forced to sort of like, you've got to adapt to, you know, oh, we have really crappy movement speed, or, you know, we don't have this, we don't have that. Well, you got to make do with what you got. And Isaac puts you in that situation quite a lot, especially in Repentance. So those can be the most satisfying victories after you're done with them. And if we end up getting a dub here, which is right now, we're looking pretty good. Despite how long it took us to get to this point, like we're not looking all that bad here. Only one hand. Okay. Deeper sack. Oh, baby. Now, I kind of wish that we didn't drop... that we didn't drop the what do you call it, silver dollar. We're gonna be buying everything here. Well, no, we don't have to buy the other ones. We do get a temperance machine, however, which I will take, and then we can buy anyway. So yeah, so we can buy these hearts. That's gonna give us more stats here, damage and movement speed. And this is kind of what I'm talking about. Like, you know, we were in this really terrible situation for this run, And we are now looking at, you know, it being pretty dang powerful. No, there's a couple of soul hearts here. There's no real reason for us to be fighting the angel statues. We've got to deal with the Preston's, and it's going to be a Krampus fight anyway, so, you know. The angel key doesn't really matter here. It's going to be war, which is not going to give us a stat up, unfortunately. Go back and go get those soul hearts from Gabriel. Can he call him or what? So as you see here, we are going to get the redemption bonus because we technically did not take Devil Deal item. I guess we're going to fight Gabriel anyway. That was a very cool game. I liked when you spawned it right next to me. That's really neat. Very wise. The wise thing to do. So if you're wondering how this fight actually triggered, it's because, well, we have Stompy, and we walked a little too close to the statue. And all I was trying to do in here was just get the soul heart, but we're unfortunately down half of a soul heart now. But we're living. They get almost a one damage upgrade for simply just not taking anything in the Devil Deal. And again, that's more than you usually get in any given Devil Deal. So I'm happy to oblige to that. I just wanted to use the Soul of Samson there. I didn't get stuck on that little ledge there. We could have gotten that entire wall down. Sometimes I don't understand how the knights decide when they want to turn around. It's almost like they're like, oh yeah, you know, sometimes we turn around and sometimes we don't. Just kind of have to figure it out for yourself. Woo. Here's our fool card. We might as well go fight the mom fight now while we're here. Good damage there. Almost a quarter of mom's HP gone. That was without having any of the benefits of Bloody Lust. Now, this is going to sacrifice our redemption bonus, but, I mean, this is such a good Devil Deal. Like, we have to take this. So, sorry, but not sorry, redemption. Because we needed something to help boost our damage a little bit here. Unequals power, of course, is going to give us more damage. And given the fact that we've had such a very strong economic build on this run, you know, it only makes sense to take it here. Incubus, of course, is going to up our rate of fire, technically, I guess. And then, you know, Dark Matter is just going to give us just a raw damage bonus. It costs us nothing to get in that cursed room. And you're seeing how awesome it is for us to be able to fire Shoop every single room. You know, it just gives you more and more power, more and more clearing power. Ooh. And you can take down the early champions. You can take down, you know, the spiders that spawn other things. You can just wipe out rooms without really too much effort. And Shoop to Whoop allowing you to have that sort of capability with every single room makes the run safer. know, it's like getting, you basically get one brimstone shot. And really that's the MVP of that whole formula comes down to trickle charge. I mean, Shoop the Whoop just wiped out. We shot once in this room and wiped out, you know, 90% of it. So it's very, very good at what it does. Champion belt's going to be awesome here. We'll donate some of our money back. I know that this is hurting our bottom line here. But like, and yeah, we could get some more stat ups there from Keeper Sack and whatnot. But there's not enough. It's not negligible. It's just not, in my opinion, worth the time that it would take to get the rest of that money and then, you know, and then buy it and whatnot. Because we're already pretty much set. You know, like we can go back and go play the Temperance Machine and whatnot, and then maybe farm a little bit of extra stats here. But we're looking solid now that our movement speed is fixed. We've got no complaints now. You know, and even then, like our movement speed is still not good, but it's nowhere near as bad as it used to be. Now, something else that was just a sheer coincidence is the fact that we have Mom's Box of Friends that we just arbitrarily bought because we have Keeper Sack. That's so huge for us to use with Incubus. And that's really going to start. I mean, that's going to pay off in a big way for us on boss fights. Having two incubi versus one boss, and we could even be using double incubus per room. Not per room, but per every other room if we really wanted to. No real reason for us to, like, there's no good reason for us to. Yeah, look at that. Shoop the Whoop is just crushing things right now. Base damage sitting at 11.74. Very, very nice. Imagine doing that room as Tainted Jacob. Ugh. Really? Oh, yeah. I should have known that. Let's try this room again, shall we? There we go. Okay. All right. Time's gonna boost our damage by a whole lot. All right, now let's go to the real direction that we have to go. Go Shoop, crushing it. Reed's Gullet is not an item that I care about. I'm going to take down the champion in this room here just because they're going to be the one that gives us the most problems. We got the boss trap room real fast. We do have a fool card, so we could bust out of there if we really wanted to. And the fool card's better used for like either a cursed room or like maybe a boss trap room. This run turned out to be very satisfying. Like very, very unironically satisfying, even though we are still going in the wrong direction. Because, you know, it wouldn't be a meme without a meme. Getting us, you know, the start that we had to where we are now. And I mean, don't get it twisted. Like we're not in like great shape here, but we're in much better shape than we were, you know, 20 minutes ago. Even 15 minutes ago, we were hurting. We weren't hurting for HP, but it could have been dangerous. Trying just to navigate through a run like that. We don't know what this is, but we'll find out. High Priestess. Outer's Rune, we'll probably end up taking that over the Fool card. Okay, Bloat decided just to not do anything. I guess he was feared. Now goes Bloat, and get another tiers up here with the eye drops. And yeah, we'll just keep rocking and rolling. We're looking solid. People have been asking me if I've seen the League of Legends Netflix special, the series Arcane, and I have indeed watched it now. I didn't binge watch it, but I was watching an episode here and there. Whenever I was, my jaw was hurting too much to record or anything. It's buttless chub. Ain't got no butt. Without spoiling anything, of course, like it's worth watching. It's very, very, very predictable, super predictable. I would say that if I were a movie critic or like a critic in general, I'd say that it plays very safe. But I understand that, you know, it wasn't really made. It was just more the series to me smacks of just something that's like, hey, League of Legends fans, look, we can make good stuff too. We're Riot. You know, and the art's beautiful. I mean, the voice acting is very good. The story is about as bog standard as it gets, but so far, so good. And if you like League, then you're going to like Arcane. But don't expect it to blow you away in terms of like new story ideas or anything like that. So normally, I mean, the story is the story, but like there's nothing special. So far anyway. But what is there is very entertaining to watch. Another 68% deal with the devil failure, and we'll just keep on going. But definitely safe is the term that I would say to use to describe the series. It's safe. Doesn't really take any chances. Doesn't really try to reinvent the story wheel or tell this, you know, epic grand story or anything like that. And for some people, that's cool. I mean, I don't really like my stories to be overly complex, you know. Because when you get a really convoluted story that has like all kinds of layers, and it's I lose interest very quickly. Maybe I'm not intelligent enough to understand them or just to get them on the first time, but like, unless if I really, really, really like a movie, I'm not going to watch it more than once. I don't want to say there's very few movies that I've watched on multiple occasions because I loved it so much. Can I name 10? Let's see. I'm not able to count right now because I'm playing the game. I just got to go through my list of you know, favorite movies, I guess. And those are the movies that I've seen many times over. I mean, obviously, you know, I've seen Jurassic Park a billion times, The Matrix, Jaws, Boondock Saints is my favorite movie of all time. The first one. Second one, stay away from that. Shawshank Redemption, you know, the usual standard fare. Fifth Element, I absolutely love. You know, all those usual movies I've seen many, 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 many times. Like I go out of my way to be like, yeah, like, you know, Jaws is on. Hell yeah, let's go watch some Jaws. But as far as modern movies go, I can't think of many modern movies that I've seen that I'm just like, man, I just got to see that again. I guess Godzilla versus Kong. Actually, yeah, that would count. Yeah. Yeah, Godzilla versus King Kong or King Kong versus Godzilla, the newest one that came out. I watched that movie like all the way through, probably like 3-4 times maybe, but like bits and pieces of it just to watch like the highlights and whatnot. Like definitely watched it like 20 times. Also, can we stop taking damage, please? No, like that would be great. That would be great. Office Space, there's another one. Seen Office Space probably more than 20 times. Without exaggerating. Not very happy with how much damage we've taken in the cathedral. This is what happens when we get distracted and start talking about other things that isn't Isaac-centric here. Now we're gonna have to beast mode here in the chest. And all of a sudden this Alges rune becomes very, very, very important. I mean, Unicorn Stump's pretty good here too, but like if you notice what's happening right now, like we're not dealing a lot of damage. Like we would have done more damage there just by simply shooting Shoop-de-Woop. Which makes me think that honestly, like Unicorn Stump's not the answer, but at the same time, if we get in trouble, it'd be nice to be able to use it. It's just the micromanagement aspect of Unicorn Stump is what turns me off to the item. Well, not the item. But the fact that, you know, we have school bags, so like using it in this spot, oh, that's funny game. Using it in this spot is just more annoying than anything. Because we have to start off with Shoop-de-Woop and then switch to Unicorn Stump. It's a lot of button presses. But I suppose it's working. Is not going to be a fun room at all. Need to kill one of them here. Good freeze there by Mom's contact. I have a feeling we're meant to go south here. Apparently it was just gas. Need a freeze conquest. There we go. And for everything that Conquest is, as dangerous as he can be, he doesn't have a lot of HP. Soul of Eden, we can go re-roll the... go re-roll the original room. So I think we're going to be okay. I don't really want to... I'd rather use Mom's Box of Friends, to be honest, against Blue Baby. But we don't have a charge. We have to clear one more room with this. Yeah, let's go clear one more room here. So we have Mom's Box of Friends fully charged for Blue Baby. I'm not worried too much about the fight. It would solidify us for us not having to worry about anything, though. There we go. Kill Gluttony last. Maybe we'll get an HP upgrade out of it. There we go. So we are going to get it after a little bit, because we have an Alges rune as well. We are going to get the dub here. It was a little bit hairy as this run progressed towards the cathedral, because we weren't really exactly fully focused on the game, so some sloppy play there and bad damage. But we are going to get the dub either way here, and yeah, it's just honestly a super satisfying run. I say that in a non-sarcastic manner. It was a very satisfying victory here that we got. No way in hell I'm fighting Delirium on this build, though. It was good, but it wasn't that good. Let's put it that way. But very satisfying nonetheless. And I hope you all have a fantastic start to your Friday. Thank you all for just helping us hit 20,000 on the Reddit. That's awesome. That is awesome. Make sure you say hello in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. It's the easiest way to support my channel. It doesn't take more than 2 seconds to do, and it greatly helps out more than you'll ever know. But I try to let you know how much it helps out, because I like being all kinds of transparent and stuff and just informative here on YouTube. So thank you for being a part of the Mosh Pit. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Katoriu, El Mazarito, Jeremy Mojaves, LaVictory Wood, Kyle Jackson, and Reagan Patterson. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/sinvicta.